Jewish family stories, when you actually examine them, they make little to no sense. Because according to Stan Lee, he came up with the idea of Spider-Man because he was sitting in his office and he saw a spider, you know, crawling on the wall, eating a fly. And if you believe that, you know, about Brooklyn and a bridge there, I also have that to sell you. But it's because Kirby pencils the first two Spider-Man covers that he becomes associated, and in Kirby's own mind, Kirby thought he created Spider-Man, but he did and he didn't. And that's the interesting story about Spider-Man. Here's the house ad from 1963, when Spider-Man 1 appears, and it's the same month as the debut of another Kirby-created character, Iron Man. Now, if you remember the first Robert Downey Iron Man movie, they paid homage to the bulky Iron Man. And here is the splash page, drawn by Don Heck, probably from Kirby Labs or just from a Kirby design. And the idea of Iron Man, about a hero that only lives because of the suit that both gives him power and life, but without it, he would die. Well, years later, when anime does Tobor the Ape Man in 1965, and releases in America in 66, that's basically the Iron Man story. And then RoboCop is basically that story too. So this is where you begin to see Kirby's influence, not so overt, but in, you know, many generations down. And this is my particular favorite Iron Man image, because it just shows you how Kirby's ideas and images have been absorbed into the wider popular culture.